What is up, Measure friends? This is Eric from Measure School. Today we're going to show how to build various kinds of buttons in Looker Studio. Whether it's a simple button like this, or navigation buttons, or buttons with hover effects, and even custom design buttons with an icon, a box shadow that you can click on to chat with Jenny here. Do not undervalue buttons. They are very useful to enhance your dashboards and improve the user experience. But what do we mean by that exactly? Buttons allow you to include your call to actions, point users to your resources, and even guide them through your funnels. For example, I have embedded a Looker Studio dashboard in this webpage, which allows visitors to come and click on this button to go to the full dashboard, to explore the data, and find their own insights. Buttons are also very useful to help your users to navigate through your reports. This report has multiple pages, but the page control is not very visible, and there are additional steps to get there. First, you have to hover your dashboard, then go to the bottom to click to the arrow to show the page control, and then select one of the pages. You can simplify this process by having navigation buttons like these, or like the following. When it comes to buttons with hover effects, they are usually useful for dashboards with dark themes or that are overcrowded with data. They help differentiate between what's clickable and what's not, and also highlight key elements. Also, if your client is using them on their websites, then you may want to use them again so that you keep the brand's design consistent across platforms. If all this sounds good to you, then let's get started and just follow along. Let's rebuild this basic button. I'll delete it. To build a basic button in Looker Studio, you can use the text icon. Go to the toolbar at the top and select text. Then click anywhere on your dashboard. Type your text. Make sure to select your text, increase the font size to 28, I'll center the text, and below, insert a link. Now, because I have pre-selected the text, it will be displayed here, otherwise you'll have to repeat the process again. Below, you can either paste any one of your links, or just click to link to one of the pages of your report. Click Apply. This is the result. Now let's add a border. Select your text box, and in text properties, scroll down and go to border color. I'll just use black. To make it more visible, you can increase the border weight. We'll select 4. I'll also increase the box size so you can see it a bit better. And here you go, you have a button in Looker Studio. Now, this is the very same technique that we have used to build our pagination that you can see here. There are, however, two issues with this technique. First, only the text link is clickable, as you can see with the mouse, and not the surrounding areas. Also, you may probably want to remove the underline. To do so, edit your button, and let's select the text box, and you can click on underline to remove the underline. First, before showing how to remove to solution the issue of the non-clickable spaces, I want to design my button a bit further, so I'll select the text box. Let's change the background color to red, and I'll select the text, change the font color to white. Now you can also play around with the border radius to design your buttons further. Scroll down, and let's select 15. And we have a button similar to the one that you've seen before. Now, to solution the issue of the non-clickable spaces, you have two options. Either reduce your button size, or another option is to add an image. For this, go to the toolbar at the top, click Image, select any image that you feel like, and then unselect Preserve Aspect Ratio. This will allow you to resize the image to the exact size of your button. Now, in the image link URL, go to Insert Link, paste your link, or click to link to one of the pages of your report, click Apply, and then go to Style, Opacity, and set it to 0. Now, the entire button can be clicked. Let's see now how to build our navigation buttons. To build navigation buttons, you can again use the text icon, and in fact, we'll use again some of the techniques that you saw earlier. Click on text, click anywhere, type a text. I'll change the text color to white, and center your text. I'll adjust the text box to the panel, and I'll change the background color. Let's resize this. Now, I will select my text as we did earlier, go to Insert Link, select one of your links and make sure that the link is related to the page that you want to send your users to. Click apply, then change the text color again to white, remove the underline, and here you go. Now let's duplicate this, select your text box, and you can either right click and click duplicate or copy paste, and you can also use your keyboard shortcut to do the same. Let's drag it here. Now I will change the text and remove the background color to transparent. Repeat the process to make sure that you send users to the right page. I have two pages, one to welcome my users and another one for traffic, so I have to set this page to the traffic page. Insert the link and change again on color to white, remove the underline. So if this happens, one trick is just to refresh your dashboard, then select your text box again, and let's change again the font color to white, and it should work this time. Here you go. Use your control key on your keyboard and then also select with the right click, select both of these text box and copy them. I'll just copy them. Go to the next page, we'll go to our traffic page, and then just paste. Now here, we'll just make sure to remove the background color of the first navigation button, and let's set it to transparent. And let's change the second one to with a background color. And this is how you get this result. All right, now let's look at how to build a button with a hover effect. To build buttons with hover effects, we'll need the help of HTML and CSS. If you're not familiar with the markup language, that's fine, because there are plenty of resources online with pre-built buttons where you can just take the code and use them here. In fact, we'll share a resource with you where you can find various kinds of buttons with different hover effects and just grab their codes and use them in your dashboards. So let's rebuild this button. I will delete it. And we'll need to go to the community visualizations and components. In the top of the toolbar, go to community visualizations, click explore more, and scroll down to find the templated record, which was built by Romain Vialard. Click on it. Click anywhere on your dashboard. Now, let's add our HTML and CSS. Because I already have it, I'll just go to style and just paste it there. Make sure to remove this code, and I'll just paste my HTML and CSS here. Now, there are two issues to be aware of with this kind of buttons. First of all, you may find sometimes that the button is cut off. And to solution this, just add the minimum width of 100 pixels. Also, keep in mind that when you're using a dashboard that has a hover effects and that you embed in a web page, because this is a community visualization component, you may be prompted with this message that basically lets users know that they must proceed with caution. The button will still work, but just keep this in mind. Alright, lastly, how to build a button where you can let your imagination go wild. Very simply, this button is actually an image that was built in Canva. Now, before uploading the image to Looker Studio, make sure to resize the image to the surrounding areas of the button and also download it as a transparent image. If you don't have access to these pro features, you can use a tool like Photopea, for example. Here, I've uploaded the image to Photopea and cropped it to the surrounding area of the button, like so. You can also export it then after as a JPEG or a PNG file. And then go to a tool like remove.bg, there are plenty of them online that makes your background transparent. You can just upload an image and it will automatically remove the background. Now in Looker Studio, we'll just delete this image. Go to the toolbar and add your image. Upload your image. Make sure to select the one with the transparent background. Now, you'll notice that by default, Looker Studio will set your image with a white background. So go to Style and go to Background and Border and set it to Transparent. Let's resize our image and let's add our link. Make sure to select your image, go to Setup, insert your link, paste your link, click Apply. Now let's test this. And here we're led to the chat page. And by the way, sorry if you're expecting to see Jennifer. So, we've looked at various ways of building beautiful buttons in Looker Studio. I truly hope that you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, Please like the video and share your thoughts with us. Anyway, this was Eric from Major School. See you next time.